back to another weekly XUR video. This week here, he's in the tower, the snowy tower here. He's just down in the hangar over here. We'll go see what he has for Destiny 2, and then it's off to Destiny 1, and we'll see what he's offering in Destiny 1 this weekend. So he's just down here. He's behind dead orbit. Up his stairs there, in his little alleyway there. This week, XUR is offering some stuff. Go figure, right? Now we gotta wait on that. So you can pick up your faded engram for 97 legendary shards, giving you a year one exotic you don't already have. Of course, if you already have them all, it'll give you a duplicate. Weapon this week, we have the Merciless for 29 legendary shards, which has conserved momentum. Non-lethal hits with projectiles make this weapon charge faster until its wielder gets a kill. Compensator, stable barrel attachment, increases stability, moderately controls recoil, slightly decreases handling speed. Also got extended mag. This weapon has a greatly increased magazine size, but reloads much slower. Greatly increases magazine size and greatly decreases reload speed. We have Impetus, reloading immediately after a kill, increases weapon damage for a short time. And fitted stock. This stock makes this weapon stable but heavy. Increases stability, moderately controls recoil, and slightly decreases handling speed. And here's what Break the Dawn looks like, the ornament. Just makes it look all white. And Beach Header 6, which I think looks really cool. The numbers etched in the top there. Looks really cool. For the Hunter this week, we have the Knucklehead Radar for 23 legendary shards. Provides radar while you're aiming, enhances your radar resolution while crouched. You can have increased resilience or increased health recovery. We have improved target acquisition accuracy and aim down sight speed for fusion rifles. Or you can have that for hand cannons. Or you can have hands on, gain bonus super energy on melee kills. Also got sniper rifle reserves. Increases the amount of sniper rifle ammo you can carry. Or you can have machine gun reserves, increase the amount of machine gun ammo you can carry. For the Titan, we have the Aeon Safe for 23 legendary shards, which I believe almost everybody has. It has Summoning a Barricade, grants the following to nearby Aeon Cult allies: grenade energy to warlocks, barricade energy to titans, and dodge energy to hunters. Other allies receive a fraction of the shared energy. We have increased mobility or increased resilience. Increases reload speed of hand cannons, or you can have causing damage with melee attack reduces your grenade cooldown. Also got sniper rifle, scavenger once again, and machine gun scavenger once again. Oh wait, I think the other ones were reserves. Yeah, scavenger is you get bonus reserves when you pick up a burn. For the warlock, we have the Apotheos Veil for 23 legendary shards. Immediately regenerate health, melee, grenade, and rift energy upon activating your super. Nearby allies recharge class abilities faster. And we have increased mobility, or you can have increased health recovery. We have fusion rifle targeting, improved target acquisition accuracy, and aim down sight speed for fusion rifles, or you can have that for hand cannons. Or once again, you can have hands on, gain bonus super energy on melee kills. We've also got sniper rifle reserves again. Increase the amount of sniper rifle ammo you can carry, and you can increase the amount of machine gun ammo you can carry. And down here, you can pick up those challenge cards for the Nightfall. They have modifiers to get a multiplier on there, so that maybe you can pass that 100,000 threshold. So there you have it. That's what XUR has in Destiny 2. Now it's off to Destiny 1, where we'll see what he's offering that this week. This week here for Destiny 1, he is in the Reef again, inside his little hallway here. So we'll see what he's offering for Destiny 1 players this week. Legacy Engram this week is primary weapon for 31 strange coin, giving you a year 1 exotic that you don't already have. If you do, of course, it'll just give you a duplicate. Not infusible, up to max level, by the way. Just wanted to add that there. We have the Armamentarium for the Titan class for 13 strange coin. Which has the perk you gain an additional grenade charge. You can have increased intellect or increased discipline. We've got special ammo, carry more ammo for special weapons, or you can carry more ammo for heavy weapons, so that's all heavy weapons, all special weapons. We've got solar recovery, increased recovery for 5 seconds after taking solar splash damage. Or you can have solar armor, which increases your armor when using the solar base subclass. For the hunter, we have the Kefir's Sting for 13 strange coin as well, which has gain invisibility after crouching in place for a short time. Melee attacking an enemy from behind while invisible delivers 4 times damage. Melee attacks apply a lingering damage effect as well. Also get increased discipline, or you can have increased strength. Got Switchblade, decreases melee attack cooldown, and bonus grenade energy on melee hits. Or you can have your third stack, you can have auto rifle loader, which increases the reload speed of auto rifles, or you can have increased the reload speed of sniper rifles. For the warlock, we have the Ram, which I think is a pretty cool look and helmet, for 13 strange coin. Has increased armor. All Voidwalker melees trigger lifesteal on hit. We have increased discipline for increased strength. We have inverse shadow, increases super energy gain from killing minions of the darkness. Or you can have heavy lifting, gain bonus super energy from heavy weapon kills on minions of the darkness, which works pretty good with a nice heavy machine gun. And we got infusion, replenishes health each time you pick up an orb of light. Weapon bundles this week at the Mighty Multi-Tool and Arctic Survivalist. And we have Telesto and Lingering Vestige probably. You can pick up each one of those for 25 Silver Dust and 30 Strange Coin. We've got Emerald Coil or Void Drive for 23 Strange Coin each, upgrading those rare sparrows to legendary, boosting their speed as well as improving their durability. Pick up one heavy ammo synthesis, or a stack of 3 heavy ammo synthesis for 1 strange coin, or you can pick up a stack of 10 for 3 strange coin. Of course, you can pick up those 3 of needles for 7 strange coin, a nice stack of 5. Those will give you a better chance at getting an exotic when you defeat an ultra or complete a crucible match. You've also got a stack of 3 glass needles to reroll those perks on the exotic gear. You can pick up a stack of 3 of those for 3 strange coin, 3 months light, and 1 exotic shard. Down here, you can pick up an exotic shard for 7 strange coin, and you can pick up a motor light to give some experience to any equipped gear that you still have to level up for 2 strange coin. There you have it, that's what XUR has in Destiny 2 and in Destiny 1. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please hit that like button, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.